holding that market clear.
Yeah, I'm already on the edge of my seat right now. The amount of times that Awoken has seen the shoulders of two teammates on Mankato's side as they begin to make that push up into A site. But it's going to be kind of hard with Astra being there to kind of hold them off and let Mankato make that rotation.
A little bit of shots going out. Nobody falling quite yet. And as I say that, Malphy and Colpan take out Wookie and Awoken, and Colpan taking out Beast Mode as well. Jackson answers back with a 2K, though. Spike down A. And now, 3v1 situation. Piece of Bread, last alive. Doesn't have the spike. Gets picked up by Unleash.
Man, yeah, no, that was an interesting play there by SMSU. Mankato was just able to kind of hold them off, stall for time using those Astra utility. And it kept them at bay just enough for Mankato to make the full rotation and take them out accordingly.
I really like what I'm seeing here from Unleashed. He's coming out with the Bulldog, second round, full armor.
Yeah, he wants that. This. He wants this. That's what he. That's what he's here for.
To watch. It's a really good buy, though. We get to see a Guardian coming out on Milk as well. I really like that. They know that SMSU doesn't have the economy to buy. If they buy a second round and then they lose, they are pretty much screwed for the next three rounds.
Yeah, you can see he's watching this like a hawk. He does get the kill on the Beast Mod with the Bulldog. That three-round burst is absolutely dirty.
Jackson, he's got to go up against the Bulldog with the Classic. Just kind of trying to throw some shots out there, get some damage onto Unleashed. You know, SMSU just playing real slow. They've got Classics. They're just trying to take a couple members out from the Mankato lineup. Not taking any of them out quite yet, though. And they do want to keep going on here to B. They have to deal with the utility, the Killjoy utility that Mankato has placed on that B site. But they are going to back off here. Just kind of rotate over to Tiles. Not quite sure. Just jiggling, peeking.
And you can even see Captain Milk is already watching mid with the Guardian, waiting for that headshot opportunity. But SMSU will get Captain Milk and will proceed to make that push up mid.
They do get hit by that alarm bot, though. Will make them a little vulnerable, but do get that Guardian. Awoken still does have it. Wookie, only 16 HP. Got a push onto site. Awoken gets taken out, and then Wookie actually gets taken out by Jaeger's bot there.
Yeah, the turret definitely.
A little unfortunate, but.
Turret acting like another player, honestly.
when you only have. Oh, we actually have a pause here.
A little bit of a technical timeout, but that gives us a little bit of a chance to kind of go off what we just witnessed there a little bit. Again, that was just some really good map control on the side of Mankato. You could even tell that throughout that whole round, members of Mankato that were on A just didn't even really move that much. They mostly just stayed on their site, just waiting for them. And it wasn't until the bullets started flying in mid when they finally made that full move over there. And that's just good coordination, good communication, and an overall great map control for Mankato. But hopefully SMSU can make something of it and try and get back in this fight.
Yeah, SMSU going to be having full bye this round, so we'll be on equal footing. Well, actually, they'll have an advantage over Mankato since Mankato will be just bonusing. You actually see Jaeger just has a sheriff there. Probably trying to play off of a kill and try and get an upgrade. But no player's going to give him the option to do that quite yet.
We'll go for some shots. They will take out Unleash, putting this at a 5v4, 5v3 now. We have Astra and Wookie on the side of SMSU. Already hurt pretty badly, but they will make their advancement.
Piece of Bread getting the 3K there. Now SMSU got full side control. Killjoy, Jaeger. Does manage to pick up a Bulldog, but only has light shields. And he's got to go up against four members of SMSU.
And with a Bulldog as well, the three-round burst may not be enough. They do have him revealed. He's probably going
to
hold that off-angle, and the off-angle does work.
He's
he will
be
not
able to
get
pick
the
up Jackson
kill,
there, but Beastmod swing out there on his concussion from his dog. And
might as well go for that trade. I mean, it works out perfectly for him, and they do get their first round win pretty still early in the game as we reach this fourth round. Still looking fairly even. The econ looking a little sus. No cap. I won't lie. It's a little bit, but
yeah, both teams kind of hurting a little bit here. You know, SMSU does have the advantage since they just won that round, and they didn't lose really anybody.
Mm-hmm. No.
Well, they lost Jackson, but able to continue over with the rifles that they had. Mankato having to full buy, however. What a slow play coming out here early on.
Ooh, the drop, though. I'm sure that members of Mankato definitely heard that drop from Awoken.
You should run.
SMSU Killjoy out will come out here, though, so that they can push on to A. It will force Malphy into that back corner in hell. But he will still be able to stay on to site. Awoken going to push in there, though, and try and clear it. Does manage to pick him up.
And you can even see here that Jackson, with a 2K, as he was watching mid for that rotation, leaving Mankato with two people left to kind of go for this retake situation. And, again, they're going for this little split here, one coming in from Tree, the other coming from Heaven. Let's see if it works out for him.
Curious if Mankato, it does look like they're actually going to be pushing onto site. Don't want to give up that early tempo.
Oh, my goodness.
Jaeger picks up Wookiee there, but gets traded out by Piece of Bread. And now unleashed in Garden Tree. Last alive for Mankato up against three members of SMSU.
Let's see what he does with it.
Does
will
take
pick up
one. Beast Mod.
Two.
Picks up Piece of Bread. Doesn't look like he's going to have the time there. And Awoken picks him up for an SMSU round win. But SMSU losing two players there, unfortunately, it's going to hurt their economy.
Yeah. Definitely going to be a dent in the econ. It will be enough to tie the series up in game one so far. However, that play being done by Unleash, if he got the kill on Awoken, would have probably been their round for sure. They would have had more than enough time to make that defuse happen. And it was up to Awoken to get that quick shot, quick thinking, and that's what's going to give them that round.
Be interested to see how Mankato plays this round. They're going to be on a full save. Do have some sheriffs. I do have a Spectre as well and a Frenzy, but you know, got those closer range guns. Besides the sheriffs, but gotta, you know, play in those angles where they're not fully taking on SMSU and all of their armaments.
Astra will be seen by the turret, so at least the Astra can know that there was a turret there, so Killjoy may not be far behind. Of course, Killjoy has to at least get away quite a bit for the turret to go off, so as long as it's on, you'll know that Killjoy is still there.
A lot of patience coming out from both teams. The World Divided will come out there from SMSU. Jackson over here on B-site really trying to sell this fake.
That fake smoke was absolutely dirty. I think it almost made the Sova rush in.
There. Will fall. Will give Mankato an opportunity to get a rifle.
Ooh, the reload. Yeah, and there it is.
Unfortunate reload on A-site. SMSU will be able to get the bomb down here, though. 3v3. Jet alts out for both teams. As I say that, Colpan picks up one with that jet alt. Now Awoken down in hell.
Oh my goodness, it's a knife fight, and Colpan comes out with the victory. It's going to be a 3K on their part. They will go for the defuse.
Wookiee is last alive, has to try and play the post plant. Words are hard sometimes.
Yeah, you know, high energy.
But
that's what we like to
see. He does get picked up, and that will be the third round win for Mankato.
Still a highly contested game, pretty close so far. No one's really gotten a definitive lead just yet, as we can even see from the timeline. It was two wins for Mankato, two wins for SMSU. So it's kind of following a pattern at the moment.
SMSU
hasn't been any leeway done by any teams yet.
We'll be forced onto a half by this round. They will have a Marshall and a Hero Vandal for them to try and play off of. Hopefully they can let that Vandal player take some good gunfights, get a couple head taps, and be able to pick up some upgrades off of that.
Yeah, that's going to be really advantageous for them if they can get something going. And it looks like they're going to go for this B push with Killjoy waiting in mid. They will place their turret.
SMSU putting a lot of utility down, but they do get stalled out by that Killjoy Molly. Now pushing out on the site. Awoken gets taken out by Jaeger. No more members falling yet. Beastmod does pick up one, but Unleashed picks up another as well.
The ult.
Spread picks up a second. Now SMSU 2v3 will be able to get the bomb down for some bomb plant money.
Last player standing.
Jackson last alive. Can't get the click to connect with the head, and SMSU will lose that round.
Yeah, a valiant effort showing there by SMSU. They got on the site. They got the plant down, but that ult Also kind of being a thorn in the side of SMSU, kind of taking out some of their people, and by the time they could get on site, it was a numbers game at that point. There wasn't much they could have done there, so hopefully they can make some moves and do something about that. Maybe bring the lead a little bit closer to them.
I think it's important to note that SMSU was on a half by there. They managed to take out multiple members of
They were able to do what they had to do.
Get it into a 2v3, get bomb plant down for some money.
Yeah.
And they're going to be full by this round. We're going head-to-head with Mankato. Mankato does have the bit of an advantage with their economy right now, however. Didn't lose an enormous amount. Didn't lose their entire team that last round, so they do get a roll over some of those rifles.
They will see that the recon dart has been taken out. Drone is coming in. It will spot one of them, if not a majority of them, possibly.
Mankato's got full understanding of what SMSU's doing, but SMSU throws down the Killjoy ult and the Sky ult, committing a lot of resources onto the site.
Oh, my goodness.
Awoken does pick up Jaeger. It's picked up, however, by Captain Milk. But SMSU now have full site control. Mankato having to play retake. Gonna wait. Bomb plant will go down now. Piece of bread gonna be holding market in a dangerous location, but
he's gonna swing for it. Does catch
Jet. Pick up one.
Could he get two, though?
It's picked up by Captain Milk on the crossfire there.
Through the box.
Gets penetrated through the box, unfortunately. Captain Milk, Jackson, 1v1.
He will go for the defuse. He is going to hold it, maybe get to halfway. He will let go.
And Captain Milk will pick up Jackson.
And that's going to be the ace
by
Captain Milk.
That's going to be the ace, the 5K.
Captain Milk on that arena. Dangerous man.
Wow. I mean, that was a really good play on the side of Captain Milk. I mean, the you saw it there with that ace. They just kind of did everything they could have done. It was a hard-fought battle for SMSU, but they just could not get those crosshair placements. They weren't able to get those shots, and you could see there that that was kind of their biggest deterrent. I mean, that round could have been anyone's game. It just was a matter of wrong place, wrong time.
Oh, we are going to see Kolpan, the op, possibly coming out. Kolpan, one of the more dangerous members of Mankato.
Oh, yeah.
Very high-ranked, immortal-level player. Going to be over here in wine, holding it down. A slow play coming out here from SMSU. They keep having Jackson push over here towards B.
Yeah.
B Hall, kind of trying to, you know. We saw him try and get the
He was trying to go for some cheeky
things. Yeah, we saw him try to get the fake earlier.
Yeah.
Really sold it. Worked out pretty well for his team, too.
Meanwhile, in mid, it will be Malphy getting
the
beast mod.
Kill through the smoke. Kolpan picking up Awoken and A main. Now SMSU at a two-man disadvantage. Wookie does get a pick mid. 30 health, though, on his own. SMSU try and play the rotation game. The Killjoy for Mankato still on that B site. Still has a Molly. Has some other utility there as well. Holding her alt as well.
Yeah. No, they're just playing a little bit patiently. Does have the world divided. Oh, Malphy going to get Wookie. Jackson's not going to be able to pick up that trade. And it will just be Jackson all alone in this situation as Captain Milk will get picked. Yeah. I mean, this was quite the game, quite the round, if I do say so myself. I mean, Kolpan with the op, definitely a threat to be reckoned with. You do not want to mess with him with that. Meanwhile, on the side of SMSU, again, it's still looking a little staggered. It's 6-2 currently. Do you think that there may still be a chance for SMSU to at least make something happen? Do you think they may be able to tie it?
I don't think SMSU is out of this half yet, or this game at all.
Yeah, no, not the game for sure. Maybe I just want to see maybe if we can see something more as the half is closing here. I'm expecting maybe two more rounds, perhaps even a full, just four round, but we'll just have to see how it goes
here. They're forced onto a half by this round, mainly a save. So, you know, they're just going to be looking to take out economy. Get a win if they can.
Yeah.
It's going to be really hard. Kolpan does have the op seller. The Astro Sun comes out.
Oh, my
shoot, misses
goodness.
Misses the first shot. Misses second shot. Malphy, though, however, picks up Awoken.
And they will pick up Kolpan, finally. They
that
do have the op down.
Really big opening pick. They're going to be forcing on to A site. They pick up Malphy as well. And now SMSU, 3v3
on
the save, however. They are going to be able to push onto site. Beast Mod getting the plant down.
Oh, my goodness.
Garden Wall goes down as well as Captain Milk gets legged there by an SMSU player.
Yeah, that might have actually been a kill if that didn't hit the wall. I think that would have been a little bit more, but, of course, they still live for a little bit longer.
Killjoy alt will come out here from Mankato. Unleash getting a pick from Hell. Beast Mod able to pick up Captain Milk. He was simply one shot.
Oh, and he will be caught.
Last caught. Jackson with the op. Peeks out and gets picked up by Jaeger.
He's still being caught.
Has to take out Jaeger.
Back his turn.
Swing out. Pick him up.
That was an absolute nail biter of a round there by the Beast Mod. You saw that he got detained by the Killjoy lockdown, which could have definitely broke the game for him there. Of course, Jackson not being able to get that op shot in time could have been a really, really big win on the side of Mankato, but they were able to pull through, get that round, 6-3. There's still a little bit of a chance for them to make the most of their situation and hopefully tie before the half so they can have a little bit of momentum going into that next round, half, I should say.
Important to note from that round is Mankato does lose the op, but I believe they have... they didn't have enough money to rebuy, so...
The op was definitely one of a big gamble, and it did work out for the most part until that last round. So they are looking pretty even.
A lot of slow play coming out in this round here.
Oh, and the Beast Mod was not able to see that. That Peeker's advantage.
Does get penetrated through the wall and picked up. Jackson throwing some shots through the smoke into Cat. Doesn't manage to connect with anybody because there are no Mankato members there to connect with. Colpan might swing him here, though. And might just decide to hold that corner.
You know, it might be for the best to just hold tree. I mean, oh my goodness.
Some random shots actually tagging up Jackson in mid there from Colpan. And now SMSU pushing from mid into tree.
And... yeah.
But Milk is sitting there waiting with a Phantom, holding a really tight corner.
Oh!
Gets picked up, however, by Awoken, and now SMSU going to signal them to push on to A. Try and get some more sight control.
Awoken's going to be a fight.
Picked up by Malphia there, however. Malphia. Jackson as well. Now a piece of bread. Wookie. In a dangerous location. Piece of bread will pick up Jaeger. Wookie gets picked up by Colpan, and now a piece of bread. 1v3 situation. Gets picked up by Colpan.
It will not be enough, but you could see that the cracks were beginning to form a little bit in Mankato's team, but they were able to kind of hold strong with there. You could see that Captain Milk on that swing probably might have not been the best case to swing out like that. Maybe if he just kept that angle, perhaps they might have not seen him, or he probably would have been able to do something with it. But again, Mankato was just able to move fast, efficiently, and take over that site pretty easily, stopping that push in its tracks.
Yeah, you know, seeing SMSU falter like this on Ascent is not something that we are used to seeing this season.
Yeah.
Typically their strongest map and the one that you definitely don't necessarily want to give them on their pick on.
Yeah.
We saw that on Thursday, and that was not great for them.
Yeah, I think the biggest deterrent, too, is that they were they excel a lot at the defense. You know, the defense is what kind of... on a map like Ascent as well, which kind of bears a little bit more of a defensive play. It kind of gives you more of an edge if you're on defense. It's one of those maps that if you can get some pretty good defense rounds in and then just hold them off on the attack, you can win a round, or if not a game, simply by just defending.
As we're doing all this jabbering, we got a big sight hit coming on to B. SMSU does have the bomb down, full plant. Have lost one member, however.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
Picks up two.
That's going to give him an advantage here. It's going to be 2v2.
Unleash, though, manages to use his Sova ult to pick up one of the SMSU players. And now a piece of bread. Or, sorry, Wookie. Last alive. Or, sorry, Wookie and Beast.
Jaeger Monkey.
I'm getting confused
here.
I'm
confused. It's all good. Jaeger Monkey was the last one alive there. That was a really good shutdown of that entire site by SMSU. I mean, Jackson with that beautiful play coming out, evening the odds ever so slightly, and of course the ults being made there by Wookie just kind of helped them even up the fight. And of course, Jaeger Monkey with only 5 HP left, it was only going to be one bullet to take him out, so it puts them up 7-4 here, Mankato still holding on to the lead.
Yeah.
Best case scenario is that SMSU gets another win here, putting this at 7-5 before the half is over.
Last round of the half. Just see how it goes. We saw both the Killjoy alts come out last round, so those won't be up to use this time. So Vault does come out here from Wookiee to try and get some tag up, get some info onto the B site.
Ooh, and
is it
going to
get anything?
Yeah.
And it's just going to back off here. Well, actually, Wookiee got picked up.
Wookiee does get picked up by the ult there by Unleash, taking him out pretty early before they can really set foot on any of the sites. You can see that right way off in the distance, Colpan was almost going to take the head off of Jackson there, but they will clear up mid, and they will decide what to do next as Colpan waits. And just domes him.
Crispy headshot. Oh. Managed to pick up Jackson. There were some body shots from the Guardian. Now SMSU Beast Mod last live has the spike, but he's up against three members of Mankato.
And they are hungry. You can see they're going for the flank here.
I think they know where he's at. His two members from Mankato push onto Cat and will take him out at tree.
And that's going to be the half there. A very not dominant game by Mankato. There was some hiccups on Mankato's side from SMSU. They were giving them a fight there. And now we're going to see SMSU on defense. And, you know, we saw Piece of Bread when he's on defense with KJ on ascent, things kind of go his way. But with a team like Mankato, who knows how this is going to swing. There's still an opportunity for SMSU to either, you know, tie it up, maybe even take the lead. But they have to play smart. They got to play and coordinate well, or they may begin to crack under the pressure here.
I'm excited to see Mankato on attack. I want to see if we get a see some high tempo, really fast executes.
Yeah, especially with their comp being just about the same as, you know, SMSU's minus the addition of Sky on SMSU's
side. They have
rain
instead of Sky, so they have a little bit.
Ooh, but that shock dart was so clean by Wookiee with that. Taking out Malphy exactly where he was standing. Like, it just hit him directly.
On the flash coming out again, deterring Mankato from trying to push more onto this B site. Oh, the shock darts from Wookiee coming out. Not going to connect with Colpan on that one. Would have killed him if it did.
For sure.
Colpan, 41 health. Market.
Oh, my.
Does get the nice headshot onto Wookiee.
Beast Mod will take out Captain Milk, putting this on them, but there's another kill, now being 3v3. And you see that Colpan is badly injured here.
But Colpan manages to pick up the Beast Mod there with another headshot from that ghost. Now a Piece of Bread stranded kind of on site. Jackson having to push in through mid.
Ooh.
Does manage to get pick up one. Can't manage to get on. Can't manage to pick up the second and Unleashed, but now Jackson has the ghost,
left.
Has to try and push onto site. 2v1 situation, but he has full health. Who does manage to see one?
Oh.
Picks up the
oh.
second, and now 1v1 situation. Jaeger.
Oh, oh my
god. Classic versus ghost. Classic
oh.
versus ghost.
It literally comes down to just who can hit who here.
Oh, and Jaeger. Unfortunately, Jackson loses out to the three-shot burst capability of
yeah.
the classic.
It just, it as
that
I said,
is
it
unfortunate,
just
but a very hard
wow.
fought first round there.
Yeah, definitely could have went down to anybody in that last round. And, of course, in the case of the classic versus the ghost, especially with no armor, I mean, a headshot with the ghost can kill, but so can that right click. It just came down to who can see who and who can
yeah,
shoot first.
The right click in a close situation like that, even after the nerf, is unparalleled.
Yeah, it is still disgusting. And as we can see here, they're going to change it up a little bit. They're going to go for the move onto A site.
They're trying to play in that smoke, trying
oh
to utilize the right click of that class that we've just been talking about. Jackson running around with the frenzy, trying to find somebody,
using
but can't
the
pick
Bucky.
Up anybody just quite yet.
Oh, he
goes
for the
knife,
knife.
Kill, but Colpan will pick him up. And now, Piece of Bread, last alive, only has a shorty. He's going to try and find something,
well,
but yeah, you're
even with
pick
the double
dig. That Spectre real quick.
An absolute fuster cluck, if I do say so myself. That was absolutely a mess. There was so much going on, utility being thrown, guns being fired out of every angle. It was a lot to take in. But again, Mankato just kind of holding it down here on this, especially after having a really good attack round. Now they can kind of sit back and just defend, and on a map like this, it's a lot easier to defend than it is to attack, so it's going to be kind of hard for SMSU to make some moves
SMSU
here.
SMSU definitely has to get some round wins here under their belt to try and even this game up for a chance to win this first map.
Ooh, and he got hit pretty bad.
Quite a few shots there, but has enough health. Manages to dash jet dash out of there. Jet. As we were all, as everyone who's playing Valorant is familiar with, Jaeger picking up a Wookiee there in market. Now, Mankato going to be looking to push onto the B site here. Has a two-man advantage. Quite a bit of damage on their Sova and their Jet. As I'm talking about that Malphy gets picked up by Beast Mod. Beast Mod picking up Jaeger as well. Now Colpan going to be looking for Beast Mod, looking for any member of SMSU to take out. Gets picked up by Beast Mod there through the smoke.
Oh.
Now a piece of bread. Picks up Milk, and now Unleashed picks him up as well. And now Beast Mod versus Unleashed.
He will get it, though, with that 4K. He's going to put them up 10-5 now. So now we get to see them finally get a win here in this defensive round. The energy has to be high for SMSU. They finally get a round in on this next half. Now see if they can hold that momentum and bring it in for the next couple of rounds, because this, you know, even at game one, stakes are very high here. I mean,
absolutely.
You give Mankato a chance to breathe, yeah, it's going to be dangerous.
In a three-game series like this, you know, that first game is everything. It sets the pace. It sets the tempo. It sets the adrenaline, you know. Which team is riding that adrenaline high? That adrenaline high, just that tempo in Valorant is so important. Colpan has his alt out here. Kind of be content to just sit around here with his team, you know. Play slow. Wait for SMSU to try and aggress.
Oh, they're going for it, too.
Throw out the dog there, though.
Oh, my goodness. He juked the dog.
Should get some info from that. And Kato's going to answer back with their Allo drone to get some info as well.
We'll bring out the Seekers.
Yep, Seekers come out from Beast Mod. Shots getting traded back and forth through the smoke. Not really connecting quite yet with either team. Kato playing very composed, just waiting for that smoke to dissipate. Get the recon bolt onto the site. Jackson will get spotted out by
that. He's going to come in and initiate, and it looks like SMSU is holding their own here. They will go for plant. Beast Mod right there to maybe pick it up. Will get that headshot. Leaving.
6-8. Beast Mod.
Oh, my
with
goodness.
Double head dick.
Give this man a medal. He just popped off. 3K.
6 HP.
6 HP with a 3K headshot on just about everybody. And he has
that
more than enough to pop
was
off.
Crisp.
Yeah, I was absolutely floored by the amount of kills that just happened in quick succession there by the Beast Mod. And on 6 health, no less. And it looked like it was going to be kind of a slow paced round. But as soon as Colpan and the rest of Mankato began making that push, SMSU was just right there to stop it from happening. They will pick up that round.
And now what we need to mention about this round, SMSU's won 2 rounds. They're forcing Mankato onto a save round.
Yeah. They have, and they're rocking pistols. If they get this, it's going to be such a big blow to Mankato, and it's just going to have to be a matter of playing it smart here.
SMSU going to be throwing out that drone in mid, but it won't spot Unleashed here as he gets into that corner. He's going to be looking at Cat, trying to jiggle, trying to find something, but SMSU not giving him a chance yet.
Ooh.
I don't know if he saw Wookiee there.
He had to have seen him at least a little bit, a little glimpse, and he,
oh my god!
Just
shoots him straight through the wall.
Oh my goodness, and now it's a 2v4 situation. SMSU has the advantage.
Stranded on A here, bombing A main, just throwing out some shots, trying to get any damage through the wall that he can onto SMSU players. And Jackson encountering a fight with the frenzy when he's got the judge.
Oh
does
my goodness!
To pick up Jaeger with his classic as Wookiee picks up Colpan, and SMSU now 3 round wins in a row.
This
looking
is
like a lot closer of a game.
This is what I was talking about earlier, right? The defensive side of SMSU, they play so much better on defense. We saw it in the game on Tuesday where they stomped against Roanoke, and that was because they started on that defensive side. Now we're seeing it late game defensive side, and they're playing really well. They gave up two rounds in the early half, but they're making moves, and you can see Awoken now has op. So, you know, we're going to see her in action a little bit. Hopefully she can get some get something out of it.
Jackson going to be sticking with that judge here.
For sure.
Oh, the early Astro Stock coming out, A-man, as well as the concussion. SMSU putting a lot of resources into that.
Wow.
Jackson has the judge,
he's
though.
So close.
He's pull it
he
out.
Is so
managed
close.
Managed to pick up one, but spike isn't able to convert it into more than one. He's not going to back off here as the defense, as the Killjoy ult comes out from Mankato.
And the world divided as well. And the ult's being done by both Silver.
From Mankato.
Oh, my goodness.
The Unleashed managed to pick up two from his Sova ult, picking up Wookiee and Awoken.
Ooh.
Oh, no, not Awoken.
Awoken still with the op, but yeah.
Yeah,
it was
Awoken has the op still. She's alive, and she's going to more than likely save.
That's got to be the play. Go for exit, maybe, and just watch with the op. Save
the
op.
It's dangerous to save, though, when you're down when it's 10-7.
I know. It's a risky play.
It's a play that doesn't feel good, but it is more than likely the correct play.
It's putting a lot of trust in Awoken as well because, you know, you're saving the op. We want to use it for that next round, and we don't want this gamble to, you know, I'd rather have you save the op, go into the next round, and hopefully win that than go in there, lose, and then now
yeah,
they have
in a,
op.
In a 3v1 like this, there's with an op.
Yeah.
It's not
there's
it's
nothing.
Not worth sacrificing it.
Yeah.
It's going to be more useful on defense.
Any other
the,
gun
in the
maybe.
Subsequent rounds, yeah. Because what SMSU is hoping for here and what they need to do is they need to go into this next – they need to win these next couple rounds.
Yeah.
So they need to have that op to give them that advantage too.
And with match point coming up really quickly here, if Mankato gets these next two rounds, it will be game one for them. So maybe, hopefully, SMSU, they now have that op again. Hopefully, maybe they put her in a different spot. Maybe mid might not be the best
Jackson.
Bet.
Jackson with the Odin.
That
is something that we do not see that often, but I love it.
Desperate times call for desperate measures in the game of Valorant, especially in a game such as this.
He decided that judge just wasn't getting him the multi-kill.
He wants
multi-kills. And, you know, he needs the judge for
he
needs
to
the
feed.
Odin for that. The Odin. He just keeps saying the judge. Welcome going to get spotted out by the early recon bolt here, though. Going to push her off of that mid-control.
Ooh.
Actually getting Astrosucked as well.
Oh, and
she does get
forward.
The dash out. She is just trying to get out, but gets picked up by Colpan. There are a lot of really great coordination coming out from Mankato to pick her up and to counter that op. A lot of smokes onto B side as well.
We'll get that.
To pick up one.
Spike down mid.
Now it's up to SMSU to make some moves here. They have to get to B site quickly.
Yeah, SMSU. Beast Mod will be rotating over here now, but Jackson still just trying to lurk in catwalk. Not there with his team as this hit goes down onto B site.
Piece of bread will take out Colpan.
Wookiee picks up one as well. Unleash, however, picking up the Beast Mod there. Ooh, almost getting killed. Well, not quite killed, but gets picked up by Jackson there in the slow lurk. And now Jaeger, last life for his team, has to contend with three SMSU players. Will hear.
He has op too.
More than likely hear Jackson pick up that
op.
Oh. And does hear it. Picks him up. Left. Now Jaeger trying to push on to B site. No point in saving. Oh, and he picks up Wookiee through the wall. Now with 19 seconds left, I don't think he has enough time to rotate over to A, does he?
From mid, he has, I believe, just a little bit of time.
Well,
he
7 seconds to play it.
Well, he's getting there right now. He can make it. It takes only about 4 seconds. He has enough time here.
Oh,
it will only take 4 seconds to plant. He has more than enough time to get there.
4 seconds to plant, 7 seconds.
Yep.
That's right.
So he has more than enough time to get there. He
and
has set
Killjoy.
Up.
He gets to throw the mollies down and just gets to play post plant here.
Yep.
That
so
is really, really unfortunate for SMSU.
Yeah, this is going to be tough. He does have his lockdown, so he could.
It's not going to help much if Killjoy just gets to back off and just double pop the molly.
And he's going
to
do it.
Lockdown will come out here from Piece of Bread. Breaks window. Going to be pushing up onto Heaven.
This at least pushes the Killjoy off just a bit. He has some time. He does take out the swarm grenade.
He gets one of the swarm grenades.
He doesn't get it. He got the other one. It comes down to this.
He gets it half.
And he will get the kill.
Dagger,
oh,
and
my goodness.
Will get the clutch in
wow.
SMSU. Wins their eighth round of this match.
Dude, honestly, that was such a play. It was ballsy. He didn't have any swarm grenades to do anything about it. He had to run up and stop Piece of Bread, and the Piece of Bread was just right there. He just had to take that shot, and it worked out so well for him. It's now game one, 11-8. It's starting to get ever so small.
This is the
lead.
Close game.
Yeah, it's
that we wanted to see.
Oh, dude, this is absolutely insane. What a way to start this final game of the season. Game
one. And Mankato on a save round.
And Mankato's on a save round as well. Beastmon will get the kill on Captain Milk, and that's gonna send Mankato a little message like, hey, y'all had us in that first half, but we back.
Mankato drone will come out mid. Does get some info onto a Wookie.
Oh my goodness!
You're getting a crisp headshot there onto Wookie.
That off angle is disgusting.
Doesn't have the ability to push in there and get his weapon, however. Unfortunate for Jaeger. Seekers will come out from SMSU, really trying to push Mankato off, really trying to force them to play SMSU's game. Woken has her ult out as well.
Piece of Bread, though, still on that B site. Yeager. Gonna try and hold it down with the turrets and the swarms. He has to stay alive, though, if he wants to utilize those gadgets.
Jaeger really, really wants to pick up Wookiee's gun right now.
Yeah, it's so tempting.
Of course he wants to. Push on, get that Vandal. Now Jaeger's
he's
gonna
use the swarms. And it will get the kill on Colpan, who tries to updraft out of there. Just not going to do it. Beastmon, and yeah, they are
Jackson
absolutely
up
putting in work right now.
Beastmon picking up Malphian. Jaeger answers back by picking up Jackson. Now Jaeger's last alive.
They have eyes on him. They have eyes on him.
Picked up by Beastmon. Beastmon with another 3K.
Yeah, I mean, this is it right here. SMSU putting in this work so late in the game, but it's working out in their favor right now. 11-9, and I mean, Awoken now has opt for the second time now, so she might be posted up in mid. Maybe she might actually go. Yeah, she looks like she's going to be thinking about either taking B or maybe even going toward A and watching over there. And
Mankato doesn't know that she has ops, so they can't hard counter her immediately like they did last time. They're gonna have to wait till she throws out some shots, so they know where it's at.
No one's watching.
Good team isn't gonna peek the op, but Mankato posturing a lot towards A right now. SMSU answering back. Drone will come out for Mankato. We'll get some info onto SMSU, and now that's gonna trigger Mankato be pushing out further. Astrosuck comes out from Jackson.
Smoke definitely comes out, and now
neither team
Mankato
losing
stuck.
Anybody yet. Woken has the op. Isn't heaven, though, is generator.
Ooh, that shock dart and the
swarm. Gonna get taken out by Jaeger's nano swarm grenade and Cellar.
He had nowhere to go.
First game dropping. World Divided will come out here
from
Jackson.
And that bulletproof wall
Jackson
helping
actually
out.
Pushing through it. Manages to pick up one, but gets picked up by Malphy.
Woken does get caught. Almost gets into the Tain as well.
No,
they will be on site.
Really awkward spot. She does pick up Jaeger there with the op.
Can she get a second, though?
Who does see Malphy there? Malphy and his astral.
Oh, she misses the shot.
Misses the shot. Picks up Malphy. Dash is out. Now he's going to be looking towards Colpan. Colpan, last of two alive for Mankato. Piece of Bread.
And Awoken is out as well.
Last alive. Has to manage to take out two members of Mankato. Picks up one.
Oh my
now
goodness.
Has to find the head tap. Bomb is down.
He could go for bomb
get
here.
The plant.
He won't.
Or just not the plant, but the.
He can hold it. He can honestly just hold it. Colpan can't do anything about it.
And
he'll get it.
Red managed to stick
he'll
the
get it.
Views.
There was nothing that Colpan could do about that. Even if he tried to go for the pen, there wasn't anything they could have done. They put it too deep in that Jenny wall that it was just not going to work out. And now, with one game difference, SMSU has a chance to take this. This is only game one. Oh, my
game
God.
Game one. I think we might be getting that three-game series.
Oh, if it's like this, please. I'll go get some popcorn right now. I'm absolutely – this is just such a great performance by the Piece of Bread and SMSU as a whole, but that
the
clutch.
The answer back from SMSU, the clutch from Piece of Bread time after time. Oh. Slow round start here at least. Both teams looking for some info. Colpan will get spotted out, however, by SMSU's drone, so they do know that he is mid. Jackson will get spotted cat. Backs off. Isn't going to give Mankato any opportunity to kill him 1v1. SMSU giving up some map control early here into the mid area. Both teams just being content to trade utility back and forth, throw some smokes out here and there.
Cover up
some sight lines, just trying to get as much information as they can to decide which site they want to push onto.
Yeah, and there's so much to really think about in this situation, especially after all these last couple of rounds that we've seen. Mankato.
The way Mankato is set up in mid, though, is just dangerous. If they get one pick, they can flood either site.
Oh,
and
but
as I say that, Beastmon picks up Captain Milk.
Oh, he's going for the swing, maybe?
The suck goes on to Catwalk there. Jackson not picking up anybody, however, with it.
Well, Colpan will pass. He does catch.
Oh, Colpan and Piece of Bread, 1v1 on B site.
Oh, they're locked in. You know this is personal.
Oh,
this is personal.
Piece of Bread doesn't know where he's at.
Oh,
and Colpan picks up him.
Didn't even see it coming.
Wookie gets caught in the middle of throwing a shock dart
he
out there and does get hit.
He does
picked
tag
up by
him,
Unleashed.
Though.
Unleashed actually getting a 3-gate. Still only as a sheriff.
If they can't plant, though, then that will be their round. But Awoken is just too far away.
They don't get the plant down in time.
Do they have time?
They don't get it down in time.
Do they have time? Oh, my goodness.
They don't get
they
it down in
time.
Time.
Oh, my God. It was a literal split second.
11-11.
Oh, my God. They were just a little bit too hesitant.
Watching the timer as they get it down, it ticks away from four.
It was
as soon as they start
literal
planning.
Split second. You need it.
Literally 0.2 seconds.
They needed at least 5 seconds to get that plant fully in there. If you're at 4 seconds, you're not going to be able to do it. It just takes – it's almost too close. You need that extra second to secure that plant, and it just was not enough as we enter a tie series here with both of them only 2 rounds away from securing game one.
I am just speechless right now.
It's up to SMSU. I know that they have a lot of energy. I know that this has been really good, but they can't have that confidence take over yet. They might go in a little bit overconfident, and they don't want to do that, or else it's going to cost them big.
Alt coming out here from Wookie, trying to get some info, trying to give SMSU that little leg up in the
right here.
Mind game of what's going on in this round, but not tagging anybody with it.
They send out the dog just to make sure to watch mid.
Mankato,
you have two members of Mankato watching to be
a
main.
A lot differently this time around, giving up a lot of that mid control.
Revealing area.
Opting not to go for those early fights, those early trades back and forth. Positioning heavily onto B hallways.
Oh my gosh, that shock dart.
They will be encountering the utility of Killjoy here. Piece of Bread. Wookie popping out there as well. Shots going down through smoke, but neither members of either team falling just yet.
And there goes the swarm. It will
swarm
hurt him a little bit.
Push out. Malphy gets a two-piece.
Oh, and they're moving. And they
Malphy
are moving.
Malphy gets a 3K now. Unleash picking up Beastmod as well. And now SMSU. Jackson last alive.
Oh, and
Colpan
is watching this with just look at the head. Look at the placement of that sight line. It's just so close.
Jackson going to push out, but going to have to contend with three members.
He gets one.
On the B site. Be looking.
My goodness.
Picks up
no
Colpan
way.
There. And now 1v1. Jackson against Malphy. Astra v. Astra.
Similar situation as before, and he's
going
to get it!
And Jackson with the massive 3K.
Oh, my God.
Clutch.
Ain't no way.
Picks
ain't
up
no
Malphy.
Way.
Clutches the round.
That's insane.
And now SMSU.
You're cracked, Jackson. You're absolutely cracked.
Now SMSU. 12-11. First match ascent. Coming back from a massive deficit.
Holy moly, I wish I could be just a little filter right now, but this is a professional stream.
I cannot believe Jackson managed to pull that off.
I am.
You could see when he was pushing down, he gets the 1v1 with Jet because Malphy looks the other way, doesn't peek out, isn't holding a crossfire with their Jet.
Yeah, I mean.
They're not sure where Jackson's going after he gets that first pick. Is he going to the left side or is he going to the right? Malphy thinks he's going to the right side. Jackson peeks out, picks up Colpan, then gets a 1v1 with Malphy, and just 50-50.
It's 50-50 right now.
Early from both these teams.
Awoken will get the first pick. It's down to 4v4.
Traded out. Colpan picking up Jackson as well.
Such high stakes here. Match point on the line!
And Awoken gets a 2K! A double kill there.
For the 3K! Golly!
World Divided comes out, and she is absolutely safe. Or no, that's not her World Divided. That is the other team's World Divided. Jaeger picks up piece of bread there.
And this is going to be the rotate. It's going to take a couple. It's going to take a good 30 to 25 seconds to just at least get all the way over
there.
It's going to
take even longer, though, because
he's taking all the
Sova
way there. Yeah, he's taking the long way
the
around.
The bomb.
This is going to be this is going to be a match of attrition here. This round can make or break it for Mankato.
SMSU not wanting to give up any early sight lines. You can see that Killjoy does have that. Does have that nano swarm down.
They have the nano swarm. They have the alarm bot. And you can see Beast Mod.
30 seconds.
Oh,
making his
Unleashed
move.
Actually cancels his. It's not going to affect him because they have enough time. But. Planted. You know, just.
Oh, he's going to start shooting through market here.
Pull cat. Both teams do have their Sova left blinded alive. Pull cat. Killed my bot. Yeah, you're playing deep on
oh
B side.
Oh, unleashed though.
Unleashed. Leash pops out and picks up a Logan. Ooh,
they will get one.
Beast Mod gonna pick up Jaeger.
It comes
as well
down to this.
Now.
And they're gonna do it.
SMSU,
they're gonna do it.
To get the pick, and that will be game point for SMSU coming back from a massive deficit.
Oh my God, they beat Mankato in game one in a comeback. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. I can't. I have no words. I have no
that
words.
That is incredibly impressive from SMSU.
My God, what a game! What a game!
Two clutches from Piece of Bread, clutches from Jackson, clutches from Awoken.
Yeah, we're. Oh my! I am so speechless right now. What a game by! I gotta say, Trump, just a great performance by both teams there. But the fight from SMSU is all that they needed.
The ability
my
from
God
SMSU to not to not
my goodness
hard tilt after getting so many rounds down and not
yeah
to just go, oh,
this is
know
finals.
Like,
we can't just give up
yeah
yet.
Yeah, it's 7-3 in the first half. Manage to come back. You know, push back, get some round wins in that first half. Come to the second half.
Yeah.
Lose pistol. They lose the second round, obviously, because they lost pistol. Managing to get a couple rounds after that.
Yeah, it looks like they're going to be taking the. We're going to be taking a five. I need a 5-minute break right now.
Yeah.
I need to get a drink. I need to center myself. This has been a lot. So
we
we'll
will
be
right back. Welcome back to SMSU Esports for game two.
Golly.
Of this final postseason tournament
oh
for Valorant.
Man.
This is Kral McGraw joined by Afron. We are just absolutely hyped up right now
yeah
after that. SMSU comeback on ascent.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, I just had to take a little drink. I'm still reeling from that last game. After such a dramatic finish, we are here in Haven of all places. This map can go either way right now. We have, you know, this has been a place where we've won. It's also been a place where we've lost. It's very split down the middle. Both teams have great knowledge of the map. I mean, if you've played Valorant, you've played Haven probably more than any other map. So
yeah, one of the original three.
Yeah, so this was definitely a map that comes down to, you know, map knowledge. And with the fact that there are three sites now, the dynamic and comps might change a little bit.
Both teams are the same
it's
comp.
It's the same exact
except for
team.
Except for Mankato. Mankato having switching out their rain out for a sky instead.
It is,
that
yeah
was the one difference between the teams
yep
last round. And
yep
that sky alt, man.
That sky
those
alt
flashes.
Is, yeah.
It is hard to beat.
The Seekers are so good. Even if they get shot down, I mean, immediately
yeah
as you
I mean
deploy them, they know where someone is. And so you have a gist of where they are.
Yeah,
I mean,
that
it just works out.
That on-command info of where's the enemy team at.
Yeah.
Oh, the Seekers are going this way. Okay, we can play around that. We can
right
try and take map control in another place. We can take that info and go, okay, they're push with the Seekers. Take
yep
map control that way. Yeah.
There's so many options.
Getting a concussion from the Seekers is just kind of like a cherry on the top.
Yeah, it's just like, oh,
it's
not only do you know where I am, I'm also marked. I'm also concussed. I'm also, yeah, like you're in a bad place.
All
and
right, game two. Standing ahead. SMSU going to be on defense this time around. Mankato going to be on. Oh. Actually, SMSU is on attack.
Yep, SMSU will start the attack just like last time. And, again, with this map, I mean, it can go either way. in this map with the three sites, you know, a lot of the defense will be spread out. I'm not expecting a lot of like four or five stacks on one site. Mm-hmm. It's going to be very spread out. So you just have to keep in mind, like, okay, so where are the strongest places? Where are the weakest places? Yeah. And let's see how we can do with that.
Both teams opting to, you know, just kind of play real slow in this early piss round, kind of, you know, feel each other out, see what everybody's doing.
Info is out.
Push is going to be coming on to A site.
Ooh.
Awoken falls there to Malfi. Because you don't have Wookiee with them either. Malfi picking up Jackson there as well.
Captain Milk not going to be able to take it there. It's going to be a 3v2, 2v2 now.
Piece of bread, too.
Oh, my goodness. Beast Mode with the 3K. It's going to go for 4, though.
Does have a ghost.
And the Wookiee will take it. What a way to start. What a way to start. Especially since
high
it went
tempo.
Up B.
Yeah. High tempo. Kills trading back and forth, back and forth,
yeah.
back and forth.
I mean, that was probably the best play they could have done. I mean, you have A, you have C with all these different corners and turns and everything. But, like, B is just a straight shot, right? You just walk up to B. It's a pretty, in my opinion, I really like going up B for, like, pistol round just because it's, like, you don't have those long, long ways where they can just see you come in. And, you know, it just kind of helps out. And especially with the amount of angles that you can jiggle peek, shoulder peek, and just kind of mess with the enemy over there, it kind of comes down to gunfights.
Both teams playing slow once again. Actually, Mankato playing two members down in sewers heavy. I believe that's because they both have shorties, if I saw that correctly. But SMSU not going to give them a chance to push into them.
This is going to be really advantageous for SMSU as they will take this, and they will have no one on site to plant, at least to defend against this full push. So
and now the double shorties, Malfi and Milk. Trying to push from the back.
Oh, and they hear him.
Piece of bread is lurking.
Oh!
Picks up one.
He's going to get two?
He's
going to
get
two?
Across right here. Not sure where this guy is pushing from.
Oh,
does
my!
Does manage to pick him up as
that reload
well.
Cheese. The reload
only
cheese.
Has 19 HP, and now Mankato, two members left alive. Yeah, you're going to be pushing out from
God.
Garage. Gets hit by that shock dart, though. It only has 26 HP with a classic.
And the bomb is getting close to being detonated. It still has a little bit of time left, but it's not even going to matter with the first flawless of the entire match. I'm pretty sure. We had aces, but we've never had a flawless.
Haven't had a flawless yet. Yeah, that's the first one.
And what a way to do it by SMSU to send it to Mankato. It's like, hey, I think we see some cracks
second forming
round,
riding
in the
that
armor.
Adrenaline high, riding that Valorant high tempo, just... They are SMSU is here ready to play.
Yeah, and especially since they, you know, with a map like Haven, you kind of have to take a gamble about which map has the most people and which map has the least. Here. They made the right decision going for C because it was only Sova, and they planted, they got control, and they just, you know, they took it out accordingly.
Kato going to be playing a lot more heavy towards this A side, and going to be having Colpan push up there, try and get some angle. Try and get some angle on an SMSU player, but get smoked off here from Jackson.
Once that smoke goes down, he does see the jet.
Temporary, though.
Oh, and they will get the trade, though, and they're going to make their moves here, possibly going toward A site, probably not going to go through.
Mankato not quite rotating over members yet. They still have their KJ over by Garage, and their Sova on C site.
Oh, he saw the head. She saw the head. She's going for Sky at least.
Has that Guardian upgrade from killing Colpan.
Ooh,
picks up
Guardian.
Captain Milk. And now Malfi in a dangerous spot. Gets picked up by a piece of bread. And now Jaeger. Going to be looking.
Spike planted.
No SMSU player is giving him a 1v1 he wants, though. SMSU might just get a free bonus round upgrade into rifles this round.
Jaeger Monkey is in a tough spot. But what a play. Throwing the swarm up there.
Great swarm grenade coming out.
Ooh, and look at this. Look at this. The crossfire working in their favor.
Holding one of the strongest crossfires in the game there, Helen Cubby.
And they know.
Very strong. And Jaeger, he can't even challenge this. It's three members of SMSU.
Oh, you can even see. I think one of them starting
to
make that move.
Gets picked up by a piece of bread with the Spectre there. Spectre v. Vandal, but he doesn't even get a chance to shoot it.
It just works. It just kind of worked out in his favor. They are up now three rounds in a row after such a dominating game.
Not just three rounds. Look at that economy.
They've definitely just they hit them hard.
6K, 5.5K, 7K.
It's looking good.
They are insulated. That was their bonus round.
Yeah.
They all had Spectres. They managed to take out Colpan, and that trade actually worked out in favor of SMSU because Colpan had a Guardian.
Yeah.
SMSU just had Spectres, so – Awoken just gets that Guardian, pushes on to A site, gets another kill, gets some more upgrades for her team.
And you can see here that Mankato's kind of switched up their movement, now going up mid, leaving A completely open here. And Awoken will take out Unleash in the garage area.
Some more info onto where Captain Milk exactly is. Could be in a dangerous spot here, possibly. The SMSU not wanting to really commit any players. They've got Piece of Bread down in sewers. He's got full sewer control with the bot there. They're going to be looking onto A site to try and figure out if that's where they want to go. And Jackson going to be doing classic Jackson things, lurking on that Astro.
Yeah, you can see your Piece of Bread throwing that in the corner, a very infamous spot. He will place the alarm bot. He will see one.
Does get one kill. Captain Milk going to pick him up, though.
Oh, and Awoken catching Jaeger Monkey in heaven here. We'll get another, and will she get the three-piece?
Looking for the third. Doesn't manage to pick up Milk, but Wookie will be there to help her out and just swing
but
out.
But the Mustangs are just there to pick up. And this has been just a completely different game so far by SMSU. 4-0 on SMSU, beating Mankato at their own game here.
I like what Mankato's trying to do on the map here. They're trying to be aggressive on Haven.
Yeah.
You know, they know that SMSU is playing. SMSU's riding this adrenaline high tempo gameplay right now. Like, Mankato's trying to not let the three sites be the downfall of them. Trying to push out, be aggressive, get some early kills. But SMSU is just riding that wave, man.
They're just riding a wave, and they're doing everything that they can possibly do, and it just works out for them. And again, the same setup as before. They thought the mid push was a little much, so they're going back to their regular schedule programming.
Just going back to a default here. Throwing that Sky Dog out through garage. Getting a little info, but Beast Mod throwing his dog out as well. Not really picking up any info, but does have the Seekers. Is going to throw them out. Is going to give SMSU some more info. Going to throw some flashes in the garage as well as they fight over this map control. They will get the control, but Colpan picks up Jackson there in the mid from B.
Ooh, he will catch him in Cubby near lock.
Now Unleash on site.
Oh, man, he's
getting
hurt.
Milk is there to help him out, trade off of him. Beastmont, though, gets a 2K there.
Was that a Colette? Was that a Colette?
I don't think so. Beast Bread taking a lot of damage, trying to get bomb down here, though.
They will get the bomb. They will get the money.
Last player standing. Last alive up against three members.
Not
he does get picked up by
it.
Colpan, and Colpan having a really strong 3K there to bring Mankato back in this game.
Yeah, honestly, I think getting that plant down was all they could have really done there. I think they just did the plant just to get the money. They probably weren't thinking they were going to come out with the victory in that round. But economically, that was a win for them. They have money. They had more money than they had at the beginning of that. And now they're sitting pretty, whereas, Mankato, they have enough to buy, but for some, maybe not as much. As you can see, Malfi only buying the
Spectre. Yeah, SMSU are going to be able to easily, recover from that round off of the four round ones that they had. They have nice bank built up. They have a full buy here in this round, and they should have a full buy next round, I believe, on all the members. Wookie might be looking a little iffy. Might have to downgrade, not go with a full rifle.
Or he can even request a gun from one of his teammates. I mean, they could most surely buy for him if need be.
This is assuming SMSU gets full wiped.
That's true. That's very true. They see that short is completely clear, but still the threat lingers.
There is all that Killjoy utility on a towards sewers.
They will catch Colpan.
Gonna get a pick up there, and the attacker Killjoy out will come out here from Piece of Bread. Now SMSU going to be pushing on to A site. Not fully committing yet. Waiting for that Killjoy ult to tick down just far enough so that it actually pushes all of the members of Mankato off of the site. Bomb will go down. Now SMSU do have a man advantage. Have full site control.
Out of charges.
And A site on Haven.
They will go for the world divided. So that's going to
be pretty hard to retake if you are set up properly in it. Okay, we're going to be pushing out there. Kill's going to trade it back and forth, but SMSU does get the advantage there. Oh, but now Unleashed. Last live 1v1.
Sova v. Sova here.
Sova v. Sova. But Wookie, he's got his ult.
He's got his ult.
He's got his ult. He just has to wait for that click.
Stall for time.
Ping.
Oh, and he's just
he
going to go for
it. Beforehand.
But that's still going to stall them for enough time. They're not going to be able to but he will get
Unleashed
caught.
Will pick him up, but
in an absolute squad wipe.
Yeah, both teams getting absolutely wiped here, though. So it's going to be a full economy reset, but look at Mankato. They are hurting right now.
Yeah, I mean, we even talked about it. They still have enough to make change, though. They still have enough to maybe buy, but it looks like they're going to probably take this one and decide not to go for it.
They will have milk on the judge, which is, I think that's a good play.
Yeah, gotta have someone at least with something.
Yeah, especially on Haven. Haven has a lot of really close quarters.
Yeah,
areas like sewers and garage, where, and even if you're playing NB, where you can really make a lot of use out of a shotgun.
Right.
And you have to push through those spots as a attacker. So it forces the attackers into a situation where they have to take those close range gunfights against guns that their rifles aren't necessarily the greatest against all the time.
Yeah, and you can see there that Colpan did get the pick on Piece of Bread, so they're down a rifleman. They do take the Seekers out. Seekers going toward mid, giving them enough information to know that there's probably not anyone at A, but that Killjoy is still around.
Also, look at what Jackson's doing here. He knows that Mankato wants to get that rifle, so he's lurking around the rifle, but Mankato is actually opting just to not push that, trying to utilize the fact that they do have a man advantage.
Yeah.
Jackson does pick up Colpan there. Really important.
Jackson
pickup.
Gets another one.
Except Jaeger as well. Milk Awoken. Will pick up Awoken. And now Wookie, the main man,
gets another. They will try and maybe think about defusing here. It's going to be up to Wookie.
Up. Wookie, last alive. 2v1 situation. Does hear
the dart.
Does hear the plink. But Malfi picked up that Phantom, and that Phantom is the deciding factor in that round.
Yeah, and they're going to come away with some rifles on the side of Mankato, and they will have enough to possibly maybe buy for somebody. Thrifty. They will defuse. They do get the Thrifty, and
that's
now
a really massive, massive step for Mankato to plink away at SMSU's economy and put them back in this game.
Yeah, and you can see here that all of Mankato has bought the rifles. You can see Unleash sitting at 4,300, Malfi sitting at 41, being able to save off of those rifles that were picked up. And meanwhile, SMSU not
forced
looking
into a really
good.
Awkward spot.
Yeah, they're looking a little bit in bad shape, but they still have enough. Awoken, I think, might be settling.
She does have her ult.
She does have ult, so she gets knives, which is still good, and she will deploy them. She does take the Sheriff, just in case things get a little hasty with the knives.
Ooh, Beast Mod just barely knowing exactly where to crouch so he doesn't get spotted out by that recon bullet.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
Pushing up really, really far here into C site.
This could be dangerous.
He's playing in the smoke.
They do take the dog out.
Oh, he doesn't get concussed from that dog, actually, though. Going to keep baiting out utility here for Mankato. Is trapped there, however.
Yeah, he's in a bad spot.
And SMSU doesn't have the bomb right now.
Mm-mm. They're going to have one of them go back and grab that bomb that's sitting in the back there, right outside of C main.
You know, just deadly spot here in the window, but SMSU not going to give him a chance to actually capitalize off of that quite yet. Piece of Bread staying back in the lurk here.
Oh, it's Beast Mod.
Unleashed picks up Beast Mod. Revealing area. That team's trying to figure out where they're going to go. SMSU's looking like they're going to be pushing onto C, but
Mankato does
have three
members
there to counter. As I say that, however, Awoken picks up Unleashed.
Ooh, and Awoken with the trade there on Malfi. It does become a 3v3. And as soon as I say that, that commentary curse coming out in full force, 3v2 now.
Yeah, Piece of Bread picking up Colpan, or not Colpan.
Somebody. There's so many. It also hurts that they are, like, the same team right down the middle. So it's like, I gotta, you know. But I totally understand. They will get the plant down. And now,
Yowdrone Mankato does come out from Wookiee there. It does figure out where Jaeger is. Now Jaeger and Milk in a 3v2 situation.
Oh, and their backs are turned as well.
Jaeger, though, does throw out the Killjoy out here, however. It's going to force SMSU off. But did SMSU plant for C long?
I believe they planted a little bit in front. They are checking to see if anyone decided to stay on site.
One enemy remains.
They have one enemy.
Some damage down there.
And they will take them out with a turret as well. And that's going to bring them up 6-2 here. SMSU's goal, obviously, to maintain this lead for as long as possible. If they can come out with these next four rounds with a win, it won't secure the victory, but it'll definitely give them an edge going into the defense
now,
round.
Mankato is in a very similar spot that we just saw last game, except it was SMSU in the spot that they're in.
Yeah. And
you know,
so it
down
really
in this weird spot in the middle of the half where they need to get some wins.
Swing.
Need to put themselves in a spot where they can go into that second half and,
yeah,
you know, come back.
A swing is definitely in the it's still possible at this point. And you can see there that the arrow being shot into garage, they are going to start popping some shots, taking out those doors, allowing it to get penned through a little bit more.
Yeah, Mankato on a little bit of an awkward buy. They do have that Bucky in garage, hoping to pick up a kill for an upgrade.
Yeah.
Have a classic on Colpan. And a classic on Jaeger as well. Two hero rifles here on the side of Mankato. And both teams just playing slow. Playing around utility, trying to bait some out. Don't want to commit too hard to any site. Beast Mod will throw out the dog here.
Oh, it will get shot, but I think he had that split second to see him. They will pop shots.
Jaeger, luckily doesn't stay in the corner. Would have been dead.
Yeah.
Holding down the other one, however, just baiting those SMSU players to push in. Now Jackson over here on A site, trying to get some info, trying to figure out if players are there, and does pick up Jaeger there.
The turret is down, which means no alarm bot, no swarm grenades, but with that pick, they're going to have a little bit of information.
On A site, but SMSU is going to counter-rotate over here onto C. They've managed to get Mankato to rotate quite a few members over Beast Mod. That's pretty dirty kill.
Barely coming out with that one.
Gets the kill.
It was pretty close. They do only have 10 seconds, but they will have more than enough time to plant. They will settle on C site, and they're going to make their defense.
Piece of bread and a
he doesn't even know.
Location picks up Captain Milk. Now. Did I say 3v2? It's a 4v2.
Yep, 4v2 here. Oh, Malfi.
And as I say that, commentator curse.
It just kind of happens. Last player
standing. Malfi gets the spray transfer and picks up Awoken.
But
now,
there's still a chance.
Has no HP.
And it's going to be
the
shock
dart.
You're cracked.
Picks him up.
Golly. And I was like,
a nail biter round if there ever was one.
No cap. I thought SMSU was dead. The entire SMSU team was dead. It was like free defuse, and I was like, Wookie's still alive watching from long. And that shock dart, chef's kiss, just so accurate with it. It's all it took, especially since he was so low on HP. You don't even really need to hit him with the full shock dart to really kill him, and that clutched the round. So big play there by our boy Wookie.
Yeah. Now
doing what he
had
best.
Now three rounds left here in this half. Mankato has to find a foothold, has to do something. You don't want to be going into that second half down 10-2.
And look how deep Mankato has decided to make this push up through C long.
Yeah, doing a lot of that Haven thing, you know, taking those aggressive pushes, trying to find some early fights, trying to get in man advantage that, you know, the three sites isn't so hard to deal with. But SMSU not giving them any chance to do that right now.
Of
Killjoy out will come out from Piece of Bread.
Killjoy does get the information as well, too, that someone was flanking.
Ooh, the Seekers actually do come out from Mankato, though, in that flank area.
Ooh, Captain.
And Milk picks up Wookie, and Colpan picks up Beast Mod.
Oh, man.
Beast Bread going to be there to pick up Colpan, though.
This is coming down here.
Is down on B site. Milk and Bread in a dangerous 1v1. Both of them going to back off.
And they will have control of the bomb here. And with that world divided, they're not going to be able to shoot through the wall. So this is going to be Mankato's round. He won't be able to make it in time.
Oh, and he doesn't quite get the swarm grenade down in time.
Yeah.
Piece of Bread getting a 3K there, but not quite enough to finish out that round. And now Mankato getting one round win here, putting them 3-7 up against SMSU. Need to find two more round wins to be pretty even going into this second half.
Yeah, they need to dig down deep here in the sense of Mankato to kind of come back and make some moves
but
here.
I think if you're Mankato, I think if you come out of this just down – well, so they come out of this 9-3, right?
Yeah.
I think if you come out of this like 7-4 or 8-4,
yeah,
I think that's really advantageous considering how Haven plays as a map.
Yeah. The smaller the deficit, the better the team will be set up in that next half. They're going to be feeling a lot better, especially getting that weight of relief that they don't have to defend three more sites anymore. Jackson just going in full pushing into garage. He will get the kill, though. And he does. Oh, my. Awoken here with the kill on Unleash. I believe that's the second kill for Awoken.
We'll be going down for SMSU. Have one man advantage, but Awoken quite hurt. Will get healed up, though, there
and
by the Beast Mod.
Look at this. He catches the Kulat. Oh, my goodness, by the piece of bread.
What are you doing, piece of bread?
Caught the Astra Lacken. Jaeger Monkey now turning this into a 4v1 in one shot by the piece of bread.
Piece of bread just out here making that bread.
Yeah, and I can't even imagine. My goodness. I can't even imagine the reaction that the piece of bread got, because he only saw the Astra. Imagine you shoot the Astra, and then you see that you also killed someone else.
Oh, it's a 2-for-1 special. Awesome.
Yeah. And it looks like they might just go with the save here. There's no point in even trying to go for it. You keep your rifle, you keep moving. But it looks like they're closing in on him.
Piece of bread.
And they will find him, and they will pick him up.
Oh, gets picked up by Jaeger, but Wookie picks up Jaeger as well. Before the switch.
Now we have an 8-3 situation, a little bit similar to what you said before, Craw McGraw, about the 8-4. If
but
they get this round, they
definitely
will.
Definitely the momentum. The momentum in this game definitely seems to be favoring SMSU.
Has Haven been the secret ascent all along?
No, I think ascent is the secret ascent for SMSU.
Maybe they're just like hiding
time
it from
after
them.
Time. We see that.
I think this could also just be that, you know. And this was Mankato's first game that they have lost in the entire season. So this is big.
We run up against two members of Mankato. But Awoken there to hold over him. Astrosuck does come out, but
that smoke was so clutch.
Throw the smoke and help him out as well. That's Masu just getting a free opening pick there.
Yeah, and again, Mankato still a little spread out here. Not going to be able to make enough moves if something happens.
Awoken gets another pickup onto Malfi there on A site. SMSU probably going to be looking towards A if they want to go for that plant.
They will get blinded.
Where Mankato will be rotated over to right now. Some shots getting traded back and forth through the smoke. Beast Mode taking a little bit of damage, but not a whole lot.
And here comes that dirty crossfire again. They do see Awoken in the corner, but they don't catch the Beast Mod.
And Jackson just doing Jackson things. There's no members of Mankato around for him to lurk out and take out. But oh, and look at SMSU just throwing out all of the ults to finish and get that final
send a message
round win in the first half.
Yeah, that was a message. They, you know, you have all the ults, you might as well use them all at once, right? And that's exactly what they did.
Last round of the half, too.
Yeah, exactly. Like you might as well. You have your Killjoy, so it keeps them away. But then you also have the Sova ult. There was just so much that they had in their utility to work out that round that it was going to be very hard for Mankato to try to do something.
Now,
and
Afro,
yeah,
if you're Mankato, what do you got to do?
Well, I would take a big breath of fresh air that you are now not having to defend three sites at once, because that's kind of the biggest deterrent of this map. It's that you have to defend three sites at once. If you over-rotate, that can cost you. If you stay in your site too long, that's going to cost you, because it takes so long to get from one side to the other. And now we get to see Mankato on the offense, seeing maybe if they can turn it around here, bring that deficit
up. I like what I'm seeing from Colpan. He's got the early pistol round Sheriff. And Wookie gets caught there throwing a shock dart. Gets taken out real quick by Malfi. He's bringing it. Flashed out by the enemy Sky.
Jaeger Monkey will take out the Beast Mod as well. Will not see Piece of Bread hiding in the door. And that's a really good, honestly, a really good crossfire there being set up by the Piece of Bread.
SMSU trying to push on. Awoken last alive, 1v4.
In a tough spot. Won't be able
to pick up Colpan there. And Mankato coming out looking strong first half.
I mean, that's
what they need.
That's what they needed. And honestly, it worked out. And like we said before, this map has all the sites that you need to defend. And if you're too spread out, it's going to cost big time. And we saw that there. By the time anyone could get to that site, bomb was already down. All the team members were there to wait, set up angles. It puts you at a disadvantage if you are too slow on a map like Haven, especially with the numbers game.
All right, second round of the half. Kato going to be looking towards C. They have the superior weaponry. They have the Spectres. They can deal with SMSU's classics as SMSU is on their
round. Oh, my goodness.
Pushing out hard on the site. Jackson does pick up one for the two. It's picked up there by Colpan, though, and now SMSU quickly falling. Awoken, last life, very low health, quickly gets picked up by Mankato, and that is a very decisive,
yeah,
superior weaponry.
There was a lot.
We're just going to win this round.
You know, and that's kind of what they do here on Haven. You know, they had the defense. They kind of got a feel for how they played, and now you can see how Mankato attacks. They don't – they didn't do a lot of, you know, default. They're not like, let's split up. Let's go this way. Let's have some people watch this way. It's just – let's just all push.
Let's just hit the site that we know has possibly one less person than it would normally have. Because there's three sites.
And you can even see the Killjoy on Mankato not setting up flank defense. So you can just leave that alone and then just go and push all at once. And that's exactly what they're doing. I think SMSU needs to adapt to that.
Like it's coming out from Mankato onto A. Some solid executes. Going to throw that dog out, try and get some info. Don't believe they spotted anyone. Drone's going to be coming out here as well. Get some info onto Beast Mod. Kills getting traded back and forth.
No.
But now Colpan getting a two-piece. Plant going to be going down for Mankato here.
Oh, and that shock dart.
Lucky gets hit by that shock dart. Mankato putting SMSU on the back foot here. Being really, really aggressive. Really, really decisive. Jackson, however, does pick up Captain Milk to even up this man disadvantage. Now 3v3. SMSU having to play retake.
Jet hurt really badly. Colpan at 10 health.
Two members in hell. Not holding that crossfire that we saw SMSU holding. Jack's going to try and drop down, get some info onto hell. Beast Spread picks up one.
The double dart.
Got to push in.
The double dart. Is
Lucky
going to do it?
Picks up Melfi. And that is going to be an SMSU round win by the skin of their teeth.
Yeah. Wow. I am absolutely taken aback by that. It would have been so easy for Mankato to take it, but Wookie. It's just that shock dart was.
I personally think that is a massive misplay from Mankato.
Yeah,
to play two members in hell.
Yeah,
if
that was not the play.
If they had played one member in Cubby, one member in hell, and Colpan had stayed behind the box where he was,
yeah,
SMSU has three more angles to clear, and Piece of Bread doesn't just get to swing out and be like, okay, I took out this one guy. I know the other two guys are here. I can just swing, and I get some bullets down. And, like, as long as I get some damage done, Wookie should be able to clean this up real easily.
I think if they set up that crossfire that SMSU has done in multiple rounds and previously, I think that would have been a big round for Mankato. But now the lead just gets bigger. It's now a five-round game for them. And Awoken cannot.
Melfi picks up Awoken there through the smoke. Really smart play there.
Crossfire being set up here.
He spread. Splashed out.
Oh, but the smoke.
The classic. Mankato finding 3-4 opening
possible
opening
ace.
There.
Ooh.
Malfi with the 4K.
Yeah, that was a really good play there by Malfi. Could have gotten the ace there, but it's not going to be enough. They will get the round, which is really at the end of the day all that matters. And they're going to go up here.
Mankato
four rounds left for them to make it.
Slowly picking up the pace. Well, not even slowly. They came into this half.
They
swinging.
Yeah, they
which
they showed off aggression. In
I think is a really smart thing
aggression.
For them to do against SMSU. You know, SMSU is dominating them on the first half. They're coming off of the, you know, comeback on ascent. They're riding the high. They come to that second half of this map thinking, oh, Mankato's just gonna they're gonna play scared. Nope.
Yeah.
Not one bit.
They don't shy away from a fight. That's what we've seen in the past from them as well. They don't do a lot of defaults, except for, you know, right now they're kind of going for a little more passive play, but at the end of the day, they just want to overwhelm you in numbers.
But going for a passive play right now is a great idea.
Yeah, they play it smart.
SMSU's mental game, they're expecting you to, like, full commit hard to the site. Seekers will be coming out here from Captain Milk as Mankato looks to be positioning with a really hard hit onto B site. They have a free site. No members of SMSU are there to contest them. Smokes are down for Mankato, and SMSU has to play retake, but they're split.
Oh, and the world divided as well. See, but the wall.
The two world divided is making a perfect X on the map right
honestly.
Now.
Honestly.
Just isolating all that sound. And Awoken doesn't manage to get those Marshall shots to connect onto Malfi. And now, Piece of Bread, Jackson last alive. Piece of Bread gets run out on and
that's
Unleashed pops right back out and picks up Jackson there in mid.
Yeah, and at that point, I mean, the world divided's come out. It almost kind of secures it a little bit more for Mankato on that site because now you have two world divided. There's no sound. The bullets don't go through. I mean, really, the only way to really get in there is to just hit
now,
a lot of utility.
SMSU forced onto a save round.
Yeah, for the
really,
first time in a while.
Really unfortunate. So this should ideally this should be a round for Mankato.
Yeah.
They have the weapons. They have the advantage.
Yeah.
And SMSU, you can see SMSU is completely stacking A site, trying to take flight.
Yeah, they
do a good eco round counter. Just not necessarily having the best read on where Mankato is going to hit.
They chose the wrong choice there. I mean, it's a gamble, especially on Haven. You choose one map. You choose one site
to
think.
Look at this.
They're expecting it. It's going to be an absolute fight here.
Awoken, actually, the first member of SMSU to push into them.
But wait.
Has a sheriff. Only has three bullets, though.
I see Jackson in the far back there, waiting in C-Link. Gonna try and go for the turnaround, but
he's hoping that members from Mankato are here that he can pick up. But Mankato planted for C long,
yeah.
And knowing that they had that full site control, they must have had a really good read that SMSU had stacked one site,
yeah,
for the eco,
yeah.
And Jackson
he's not gonna be able to do a lot.
I feel like he's just gonna run into Mankato here and try get a kill.
Yeah, and it's not going to be enough.
It's better for him to run into Mankato there,
yeah,
with the Bucky and die because otherwise he wouldn't get the round loss money.
And the tables have for sure turned here. Mankato now up pretty well in Econ, whereas I do see the op being used by Awoken. They are on defense, so it's going to help her out a little bit. SMSU as a whole needs to make
SMSU
a big read
does
here.
Have some tools to play with. They've got the op. They've got the Killjoy ult.
Yep.
They've got the Sky ult.
Yep.
So they have some tools to, you know, push Mankato off, but you know, the Killjoy ult, not as strong in a map that's got three sites, right? Like,
ooh.
And Kolpan getting that early pick onto Beast Mod, playing that high tempo, takes quite a bit of damage. He's going to get healed up by his Sky. So you're going to try and get some info. Throwing the drone out. They do get some info as to where the members are. But Jaeger going to be throwing out his Killjoy ult. Malfi picking up Jackson as I say that. The Killjoy ult going to be coming out from Piece of Bread, countering the Mankato's ult. And now both teams kind of scrambling, trying to figure out where they're going. But
Mankato looks
quite decisive,
yeah,
in their push onto A. And now SMSU had rotated two members over onto C. And now Wookie, last live, pushes out of the smoke and gets picked up by Jaeger. And now 2v5 situation. Not a single member of Mankato has fallen yet. SMSU.
And they're going
to
take it easy.
They're going
to take it safe. Yeah, I think that's the best play. Mankato has just been really turning it around here in these last couple of rounds, and that's really good from them. They've been playing very aggressively, and they've taken enough of that to, you know, and I feel like also that big misread on SMSU's part that really cost them, I think that hurt them almost. Having to, like, I get that it was also it was also a save round. They didn't have a lot to use for the counter, but I think just having that wrong move of being on A rather than C was what did it. But
Mankato possibly hunting.
Oh,
Awoken
does
hit the op shot there onto Milk, though. Milk
she
gonna
will
re-peak,
get it, though.
Does pick up Milk, so that is at least one member.
Two.
Oh,
man. Awoken
does get two kills on a Mankato, though.
That's some extra econ.
That's important. It's going to hurt their econ. Not going to break it whatsoever, though.
No, they're still going to be
their
good.
Their econ is quite well set.
And game begins to get a little closer.
Can I start to say, we might see a Game 3 Breeze?
Game 3 Breeze? I mean, it is possible. It is for sure possible here.
It is 100% in the realm of possibility. 10-9 now.
Yeah.
Mankato only down by one after being at a 7-round deficit.
Yeah, they were pretty down bad in the beginning of at least for that first half, but in the second half they've shown that they are extremely really good at attacking.
By C, Mankato just full executing onto that site. They have the world divided down. They have everything down.
Oh, and Kolpan
pushing out here, picks up one.
Gonna
being
catch
real aggressive. Just gonna be satisfied with getting that man advantage though. Back out onto site. Mankato got that full site control. SMSU, you're going to have to make some type of play. Something.
Yeah, and they are, you know, they're putting up a fight, but right now, based on this map placement,
and
my Kolpan gosh.
Goes, we gets a 2K!
Wow!
Kolpan, you can't be doing that.
But Beast Mod answers back, though. No, oh, but he's not going to be able to do anything about it. He does get the 2K.
Malfi going
to
pick up Awoken.
Oh.
Oh, Cole Pan. Oh.
He is just really good.
That.
Cole Pan is just, he's just, I mean, he ain't top bragging right now. That belongs to Malfi, but crispy. Cole Pan is just too quick with it. My goodness. And again, now tie game, very similar to the Ascent matchup that we just saw. And if this goes to game three, we're going to be seeing SMSU on defense this time to start off on three. So on a map like that, I mean, it can really come down to
SMSU
who can win.
Another save round this time.
Yeah. Oh, also, yeah, I just noticed too.
Two shorties, a judge, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I believe Jackson has the judge in sewers.
Standing ahead.
And Gato gets the opening pick on a piece of bread there. Just going to be real aggressive towards the C-site. Malfi picking up a Wookiee. Awoken trying to push out with that shorty. Doesn't manage to pick up
the
anything.
Dash forward.
Gets picked up by Unleashed. Beast Mode, though. Gets a 2K with the Spectre. Is expecting Jaeger. Gets
a
3K.
No way. He does pick up the Vandal.
Does get the upgrade. Only has 21 health, however. Jackson has the judge.
He is looking really hurt.
That dog onto site. Get some info.
This can still go either team right now. They just need to think and coordinate.
Jackson going to run over, get an upgrade as well from those kills that the Beast Mode had gotten. Now Beast Mode throwing out some flashes onto site. Jackson pushing on.
Oh!
Jackson trades out Beast Mode for Malfi.
He just needs to shoot him. And he does get him!
But he doesn't have time to get the defuse.
Oh, it's just not enough time.
And that will be a very, very close round going over to Mankato for them to have the lead for the first time in this match.
Yeah, honestly, it was a hard-fought battle by SMSU, but Mankato climbing up that deficit, just climbing up that mountain, being able to come out on top here now, 11-10, round 22 in this, essentially this Iron Man contest of these two teams, these two highly rated teams, and this can still go either way. Mankato's looking really strong right now, though, with those aggressive attacks that they've been doing constantly. I haven't even really seen him on A that much.
Out once again, over here on C long, Mankato looking to posture over towards C once again. They throw out that smoke. Gonna have the drone go out as well. Gonna ping out Awoken with that drone.
The Seekers do come out as well.
Now a lot of tempo coming out from Mankato. Not quite fully pushing on the site yet. Clearing out the corners. Cole Pan is now on that site really hard.
He catches Cole Pan though. And he's just shooting.
He is just shooting here. With that, Odin has to reload, but Awoken does get a pickup there. Piece of bread getting one as well, and now SMSU, two-man advantage.
And the other just taking shots.
Just content to throw those shots back and forth through the objects.
They will go for heal.
Malfi and Milk, though.
Oh, and they know exactly where they are.
Awoken's got him pinned down with that op, ready to just lean him out if needed. The smokes will come down there for Malfi, though.
Ooh. This could be
counter.
Doesn't quite
get the shot to connect with Malfi.
She does get it though, and it's gonna be an 11-11. It's
as
so close.
Beast Mode picks up Milk, and it is a tie game. I think we might see a game three.
I have no idea. I'm gonna keep it real. I mean, this could still be anyone's game, even when it's 12-11. You know, it's still like, even at that point, I'm still like, it can go either way right now. This could be all she wrote if SMSU just gives more of a fight. They just need to dig down deeply. They have to, and they've been doing so. They just need to hold on for just a little bit longer, and they can secure this victory and end the season with the biggest W.
As the op gets flashed out, though. Now Cole Pan going to be peeking into her, and Awoken picks up Cole Pan. Massive, massive opening pick there from Awoken.
Especially taking out one of the strongest players on the team. Cole Pan has been an absolute threat, and taking Cole Pan out definitely leaves them in a juxtaposition of sorts.
Now, Mankato, not looking quite as decisive, losing Cole Pan. World Divided will be coming out for Malfi, though, for an A hit. But SMSU is fully expecting that. They are there, rotated over for them. All the utility coming out from SMSU. Milko gets a two-piece onto site. Now SMSU, Jackson not there with them yet. Beast Mode gets picked up by Malfi.
He cannot shoot through the wall, though.
Has to try and wait for that World Divided to drop. Jackson going to try and push in there. He is smoked off.
One of the walls do go down. So they do have a chance to make something happen.
Jackson does push off through the smoke. He's looking for any members of Mankato that he can pick up. However, none of them are giving him the option to do that just quite yet. Awoken looking as well.
Ooh, oh, she checked the crossfire spot. Does notice that there might be somewhere in heaven.
Off, but she picks up the Phantom.
She does get
picks
one.
Malphie.
Jackson's
Jackson
down
picks
as well.
Jaeger.
Jackson will go for the defuse.
Now
he will go for ult.
Pushed off, but the snowball does come out.
Just needs to get it halfway. He will get it to halfway. Will he get it all the way? He's going to keep holding it, and he will do it.
SMSU does manage.
And the pick.
Round.
Oh. Oh, my goodness.
SMSU digging deep, finding those little advantages.
And this is it. This is it for SMSU. If they can just hold on for one more round. Energy is high. The confidence has to be overflowing right now. But they got to keep their wits about them, and they need to play smart here. Awoken has op. We have a couple rifles, and we also have the Odin from Wookiee. Now they just need to play smart and be able to adapt and or read Mankato here.
Mankato looking to go aggressive towards B.
And he's just popping
playing
shots
heavily towards that garage. They do smoke Wookiee off quite heavily, though.
Astra is also heavily injured from that barrage of bullets. But they will get healed up.
Both teams, both players. Mankato has quite a bit of that garage control, but they don't have control of window yet. It's just smoked off. Mankato, or Wookiee, more than happy to just play back on back C site outside of that garage entrance, just so that he can penetrate through it with his Odin if he wants to. Really put the fear of God into the Mankato players.
And this is so intense. A Mexican standoff, if you will.
Jackson,
both teams not sure what to
the
do.
Smoke. Unleashed has a dart ready.
Oh, he sees the dart, though.
Sees the dart pop out. Jackson will pick up Unleashed there.
Will he get two? Yes,
does
he will.
Pick up Jaeger as well for the two-piece.
There's a third. Oh, my goodness.
Malphie swings out, though. Picks up Jackson, though.
And it's
now,
just Malphie. And that's going to
that
do it.
The SMSU win.
They've done it. They've done it. It's over.
Oh, that is amazing. SMSU, the season finale.
Oh,
final
my
tournament winners.
God.
They come back. They fight against Mankato. They hard comeback
holy
in the first ascent
moly
game.
Yeah, I mean, the story was there, right? You had Mankato on the precipice of winning game one, and then
haven't lost a single game yet this season.
And it was in finals where they lost their two
SMSU
games.
SMSU goes up against Mankato before this. Mankato 2-0s them.
Oh, my goodness.
And now SMSU with the 2-0, with the comeback
to
win the season finale tournament. There's nothing we would
There's nothing
see.
Better. There's nothing better. I mean, this was an absolute barn burner of a game, especially Ascent, where they dug down deep and come out with the comeback victory. And then Haven.
Haven, too.
Yeah.
That is so hard to not tilt.
Oh, yeah. It was so close.
You come into that second half. You've been dominating. They get a win streak.
Yeah.
They come back. They win the rounds over and over and over again. And your mental starts to kind of go away. And you're like, oh, crap. Like, are we going to be able to beat them?
Yeah. But they decided, like, we can't give up. We can't get tilted. This is finals. We've already worked so hard to get here. We might as well just wing it and go for it. And they fought hard. And they finally beat Mankato in the improvement as well.
Such a hard-fought game for both teams. We got to give props to Mankato. Like,
yeah.
Mankato's
a tough,
they weren't
tough
out of that
opponent.
Second game. They lose the comeback on Haven.
Yeah.
They come back and Colpan leading his team just forward with all of the utter aggression.
Yeah.
Pushing on the site, getting 3Ks, getting trades, playing well, but it just wasn't enough. SMSU came into this hungry.
Yep.
They came for a comeback.
And that's what they did. And that's exactly what they did. What a way to end the season with SMSU on top.
We may not have gotten that game three breeze. I don't think we need a game three after we watch two games almost go into full overtime.
Yeah.
That is
I'm
insane.
Absolutely. Yeah, no. I have to give props to both Mankato and SMSU. They fought hard. Both teams did so well. But it was just the drive. It was just a fight from SMSU that was coming out on top. And they finally beat the team that had destroyed them in the regular season. It must feel so cathartic to just I cannot believe it. I am absolutely speechless. What a season. What a game.
What a semester.
Honestly. Oh, my goodness. But well, I think that's it for us here.
Yeah, as we wrap up here, we want to thank everybody for tuning in and watching and coming to see us talk and coming to see SMSU play.
Yeah.
And we couldn't give you a better two games.
Yeah, honestly.
For the end of the season.
Yeah, and this is the end of competition for this semester.
Yep.
But we will be back in the next semester for some more high-octane games. So, from us here at SMSU, this has been Afro.
And this has been Cra McGraw.
And we'll see you guys next semester. Oh, my goodness.
Thank you for joining us.